Alrighty, so I'm gonna take the Ninebot out wearing my motorcycle helmet because I have a camera on it. So, give me just a second. I'm very curious to see how this is gonna go. So, alright.
Alrighty, so let's get some sick footage, shall we?
So, I'm gonna be wearing my motorcycle helmet because it has a camera on it, and I'm gonna ride the Ninebot for a little bit, so you'll see the footage from this thing shortly.
Let's do some slides. Actually, I think that's where I wiped out, isn't it? Yep. I wonder if you can see the Ninebot from there when I look down. Footage on here. So this thing goes 18 miles an hour top speed for about 13 miles one charge, and what's cool about it is it's one giant, pretty much, I think it's like an 18 inch wheel or something like that. Obviously bigger than a bicycle, standard bicycle wheel, but because it's so large, you don't feel anything underneath you. Even if you're going over rocks and big bumps and stuff, you don't feel any of it. It's very minimal. Even going off curbs, it you don't feel it that much. It feels like you're just jumping, like a short jump. I mean, I can just look at how bad this is. I mean, yeah, it's like nothing. And then it's like, this is completely uneven. Here's a little bump there. Here's a curb. Let's see if we can go off the curb here without fucking up there. All right. Yeah. I like just going back and forth like this because it's so smooth. Even if, like, you can go really, really, really low and scrape your tire on it. I look completely ridiculous right now, and that is okay. I'm wearing a fucking motorcycle helmet on a Ninebot. Oh. It is lunch hour right now. I'm not hungry, so I am just having some good old-fashioned fun here. Let's go over here, shall we? Let's go up to Midtown here and say hello. On a scale of 1 to 10, how ridiculous do I look?
I look good.
Yeah? I think I look ridiculous. It's awesome. All right. wish the skate park was open. That would be freaking awesome. So, let's see, let's go up over here once. Through water, snow, mud, ice, all that stuff. Goes through it like nothing. I mean, this is like completely uneven sidewalk. I mean, look at this, look at that. Completely broken. There's glass and stuff here. And like, all this stuff I've already been through a lot. Sidewalk is covered. Let's go this way. See if I can make it through this little guy right here. Go a little slower just because. Yeah. See, I've gotten to the point where I'm very comfortable riding this thing through even really difficult terrain and stuff. And oh, look at that. Oh, yes. Look at that.
Mike, you still work on computers?
Yes, I do.
You do, huh? I got a brand new one. I used it last year about a couple times. Shit. Mm-hmm. So where's your office at?
Right there, Custom Touch.
Okay.
Yep.
What do you usually charge for that?
It's $50 an hour.
$50 an hour?
Yep.
Okay.
You just want it cleaned up and sped up and stuff like that?
Yeah, because I want to implement it back into to get kids' programs and everything.
Okay.
Well, I was going to ask you, what the hell is that?
That is the Ninebot 1C Plus. It's an electric unicycle. And I just had the brilliant idea to put on my motorcycle helmet because it has a camera attached to it. And I want people to see what it's like riding this thing.
Yeah.
So, yeah. I know I look completely ridiculous with a motorcycle helmet on right now, and I'm completely okay with that.
Yeah, my daughter has seen that. I want one of those.
Yeah, 18 miles an hour top speed for 13 miles on one charge.
Man,
thing's pretty sick. Yeah.
It's pretty cool.
Yeah, it's awesome. I've gotten to the point where I'm very, very comfortable riding it and stuff. Now I'm challenging myself, trying to see, like, I can go off curbs and gravel and dirt and mud and all that stuff.
Yeah.
And now I'm just seeing, you know, like, I'm pushing it to its limits right now. Like, just, I'm always topping it out in the speed and everything, and just, yeah.
Yeah, so I'll bring that over maybe in a couple days or something.
Okay, yeah.
All right, thanks, Mike.
Sounds good. See you later. All right, let's see if I can. All right. Why does my foot feel like it's off in there? Feels like the thing is off a little bit. All right, feels like my foot is off. Like really, really off. There we go. Much better. Okay. My foot was scooted way back. So all this stuff is like uneven. This is not smooth. This is a fun place. This is the church parking lot right here. And this is a really, really good place just to get your skills going. I mean, I've gotten to the point where I can go slow and I can go like really, really, I don't know if you can see that, but I'm just going really, really slow and taking really, really tight corners. And that's how I got to the point where I can take the corners as well as I do. As I sat here forever just doing this, just getting the feel for where it's comfortable so you can feel the angle that you're supposed to be at. And it's just, it's a lot of fun. This thing, it's not meant to be a toy. This is a business travel vehicle, but obviously I'm just like a giant kid, so I just use it to ride around and everything, you know. Like right now, lunch hour, just having some fun. And it's great. I think what I might do now is go to Booms. I actually am kind of hungry, so maybe I'll stop by Booms. I stopped by there yesterday just to get some stuff to snack on. Looks like I know that the sidewalk right there is bad, so we do have to cut through the IHS here. So let me just mosey on down here. And actually, that is the corner where I'll have to get off over there. I don't know if you can see it from here, but the corner right over there, I'll have to get off this thing and walk it up on the sidewalk because it's all straight, just a big old block of snow and ice that's covering the entrance ramp to the sidewalk. So, but maybe it might be melted. We'll see here. No, it's not. Not even close. Okay. So, yeah, let's go down there. There we go. I don't even know how much battery life is left on this thing, so this will be interesting. Now my shoes are all slippery, so that's one thing, is I gotta fix the grips on it, because the grips are, they're okay, but once your legs are wet or the thing is wet, it gets really, really hard to actually stay on it. Especially if you hit something or take corners, your feet really slide off. That's the only downside. This is just the cheapo version of it though. Let's see though, it is 12:15, so you got time to get a little cheeseburger or something. All right, shall we? Done eating there. And I got about 13 minutes to kill. So I'm gonna have myself a good old time here messing around the nine bot. Oh yeah. Bump. Here we go. Awesome. like nothing. Like that. You can't do that with a hoverboard right there. None of this stuff. You couldn't. You'd be going half a mile an hour, if that. Up over here. Yeah, none of this you can do with the hoverboard. Whew. Oh, this is ice. Oh, it's all ice. Oh, my worst nemesis, mud. Oh, God. Awesome. I didn't get launched from my thing this time. And again, I wasn't going full speed there. Learn my lesson. Never trust mud in South Dakota because you never know how deep it is. Last time, I wrecked for the first time 2 days ago. And there was a little patch of mud just about that big. It was actually over here on the left. Let's see if I can show you where it's at. But I was like, you know what? I'm going to try and see if I can make it across, you know, like, what if, you know, let's pretend, what if someone's riding this thing and they're not paying attention and then they come across something like that? What is going to happen to them? Well, this is what happens. Let's see if this, yeah, this is it. You can see where my tire just dug in. Oh, let's see if I can do it again. Going slow. Yeah, there we go. All right. Conquered my fear there, guys. All right. I got a message, so let's find out who that was. Mom wondering if I can handle the shop until 2. Yeah, I suppose I could. I just love swaying back and forth in this thing. It's so smooth. It's like a one-wheeled rollerblade. It's basically what it is, you know, obviously. Rollerblades are, what, 8, usually? 4 per foot. This is like a one-wheeled rollerblade if you make it like that, you know? I mean, if you want to sway like you would in rollerblades and stuff, you can do that. It's really smooth, though. It's a lot of fun. Bam. Love this thing. I look completely ridiculous right now, and I don't care. If anyone asks, I'll just say I'm wearing this for protection. Totally not because of the camera on it. Like, that wouldn't have anything to do with it. It's much better having the camera on my head than me holding the camera with my hands and then me falling because I'm too busy trying to get good video. This is looking, the camera is lined up exactly where my eyesight is, like the middle of what my eyesight would be. What time is it? I didn't even look. It's gotta be getting close. 41, 19 minutes. Before I said 13 minutes, that's before, like, that's just, like, you know, safe time, like, playing ahead, you know, safe time to get back, but 19 minutes before it's 1 o'clock, before I actually have to be back here. Boop. Yeah. Look at the boobles. There's a lot of boobles. Cool. Yeah, if you have a hoverboard, you'd have to take all of these at, like, an angle and only get one tire up at a time. it takes so much longer, and you can't go this fast and maintain your speed because you're always being forced to lean to the left or the right to like counterbalance yourself. With this, I can sit here and wobble my legs and it's fine. It doesn't matter. Let's try going through the mud. Woo. Getting a little dicey. Oh man, this could have been a mistake. I'm sinking. Oh, the mud is so thick here. Holy crap. I made it. I can't believe I made that. Look at my tires for a second. Oh shit. Yeah, my feet got muddy there, so now my feet are sliding. But look at that. Look at that trail. It's still going. It's insane. Yep, my shoes got muddy. That's why I was slipping so much there. You can even see my track all the way up there. That's great. That is great. All right.
Mr. Pettit.
Hey! You too, see you later.
Yep.
Alrighty. Boop. It's funny people even recognize me. Maybe it's probably because of the nine bot. Oh, I'm just a big old kid. That's all I am, I'm just a big kid. Alright. Getting a little dicey. Wow. Oh, it sucks. It's hard taking turns when your shoes are muddy. Oh, that means it's 12:47, so I got 13 minutes from right now. Or 12:46. I don't know why it's at 46. Oh, it's because it's set to go a minute early. Yep. So, 14 minutes then. I'm excited to see the footage for this thing. Oh, man. What's nice about this is that you can ride this thing in the winter for the most part, you know, as long as there's not a whole lot of snow. But you can ride this in the cold is what I should say. And you're fine. Obviously you yourself are gonna get really fucking cold, but I love riding motorcycle. I don't know what it is. Maybe it's like the less wheels the vehicle has, the more fun it is for me. But because I can't ride the motorcycle right now, because I would obviously probably freeze to death, you know, obviously because it's cold out and then wind chill and everything. Riding this thing is just awesome. I can't explain what this feeling is like. It's like I'm getting to ride a motorcycle in the winter, whatever I want. But it's just easier. There's less setup and everything, you know? It's just grab this thing and literally go. But. And obviously, this is safer too. You're not gonna die if you get in a wreck, so. Unless you get extremely unlucky and like smack your head against the wall and you're not wearing a helmet, that would suck. But, oh man. This thing is awesome. And yes, I look to my left there, peripheral vision. I know it can't show in the camera because the camera only goes where my head is pointing, but trust me, I am looking both ways just with peripheral vision. Boop. That is a big dip of mud, holy shit. Minutes. Ugh. Ooh, I kind of want to go over that. I just love swaying back and forth. It's so much fun. Even going between places like here usually isn't a problem, and balancing that shit. Cool. Wonder if I can go up this. No problem. Thing. Boop. Suppose it's time to go inside. Nope, it's only 52. Still got a whole 8 minutes to mess around on this thing. Oh, getting a phone call. Hey, Mom.
Hey, Michael. Did
I? Yep, I did. I just haven't been able to respond. I'm still riding around the Ninebot. Yeah, that's fine. I'm not going anywhere. Yeah, I'm not going anywhere.
All right, sounds good. I'll see you at the shop then.
All righty, sounds good.
Okay, thanks.
Yep.
Love you.
Love you, bye.
Bye-bye.
All right, let's try going through the gravel here. So this is giant freaking rocks. Oh, I'm sinking. I'm sinking. Still faster than walking. Plus, you're not getting your shoes dirty. Oh, yeah. Give the ground some love there. Skirt. Oh. Let's try this again. I'm gonna go through really, really slow in here. I just wanna see how slow I can push it. There. I was wondering if I hit that going really, really fast. There is a chunk because the sidewalk and the curb, they don't match up evenly. So if you hit it too fast, your tire's gonna catch and you won't be able to turn. So the thing, you're gonna turn and the Ninebot won't, and you're gonna go flying. That is what happened to me over there by the buoy's headquarters, is they have cement that is unlevel. And when I was swaying back and forth, I didn't even notice the, you know, difference in the levels of the cement. And I was doing this, and when I was going to the left, it caught, and the Ninebot stayed, and I shot to the left. It was pretty funny. Thankfully, I didn't get hurt at least, but... Yeah.